Based on this track, fam.
What's happening, Captain? This your boy CB Hunts. And what you have before you is the McFarlane Toys, DC Multiverse, Green Lantern, John Stewart. Man, when I saw this, when he was showing pictures on his Instagram and video as well, I just figured, you know, your boy had to have this.
He ain't lying.
And this mug look off the chain. It looked clean, man. I like how this figure looks. And you see how it looks in the box, looking off the chain. You know the type of box that he always uses now. All black blocks, trimmed in white and blue. Got the DC logo, name of the figure right there. Seeing everything inside the box, so showing John up in there, looking clean. On the side of the box, shows the name, Green Lantern John Stewart. And this is part of the Rebirth. Comic, whenever it came out. See on the back of the box, see John Stewart right there, looking clean. Image and all the figures are coming that wave, as you can see. And this side is basically a little window logo, and with his name as well. And trust me, when we get back, we're gonna have this bad boy out the box, and we're gonna see what to do with a John Stewart. And now we got this bad boy out the box. Man. This mug look off the chain.
He ain't lying.
But trust me, dude got some like design flaws that I was kinda like iffy on. It just won. I believe. It just won. I was like, okay, why would you do that? But other than that, I love it.
He ain't lying.
But you know, when we're falling toys, they got the infamous black stand with the logo on it. As you can see, that's all it is right here. Next up, John, you got his card, the same image on the back of the box. Love the way this looks, looking clean. And on the back of the card, it has a bio. So if you want to read it, pause it. Here it goes. Now, we come with John, come with two extra pieces, more of his ring effects. Come to find out, instead of two, he actually got three. But we'll talk about the third one in a minute. First things first, we'll talk about one of his effect pieces, is his backpack. Backpack where he got all the bullets in, I guess. Where he holds a gun. Where he'll be able to unload on folks. That little pig on the back. It's see-through. It's clear. Looking nice. Up next is his big old Gatling gun. And this mug look clean. This little mug, like, it'll lay somebody down. I love the barrels of this. Looking quite nice. It reminds me of that gun off of the first Predator that I've got the dude's name, the black guy's name in the movie. But he had that gun. No, actually it was Jesse Ventura, he had it first. Not gonna say what happened, but you need to watch it. But they just say them two people had this gun. And when they tore down a forest, here they went just going off, man, it was crazy.
He ain't lying.
So this type of gun, it like remind me of, I don't know what it's called. So if y'all can help me out, cause I don't know anything about guns all the way. So if you can help me out, I will gladly oblige and say thank you. So with that, We gonna talk about the main man himself, John Stewart. Man, his mother look clean. As you can see, the detail on John's face is crazy. His hairstyle, nonetheless, his fade he got is horrible.
He ain't lying.
You know, the sideburns are like way too high, or he don't even got sideburns. It just looks weird. But other than that, I like the design of him and everything else. Suit, the way it looks. Designs. Suit looks clean. Looks like he got armor plating going around. Size under the tights, the boots. Looks phenomenal. Ain't too much detail, but looks nice. Well, the way the suit looks. And like I said, the third piece he has is this piece here. It's more of his it's like ring of effects, and you can't take this off. So one of our shows has comparisons. I'm gonna take it off now. Hold on. Let me take this off now. So you be able to see it without it. I think the suit looks a whole lot better without it. And voila. Looking quite nice. This is how I'm going to have him on my shelf, though. But he looks clean. I love the way the suit looks. Got that old school type of a John Stewart look. I like the way it looks. You can actually see everything real well. And with John, does has his ring, as you can see right there. Good look. Have a close up, but I wish he had like extra hands. Wish he like had a fist instead of these doggone, trigger fingers. I'm just tired of these damn trigger fingers. Like, have some extra hands, man. Trust me, I love the line. I don't know if you watch this, cause I heard you do watch reviews, so hi. But if you do watch these, just please, man, not all of them have to have trigger hands. Like, if you're gonna have trigger hands, at least have like an extra pair of fists. I'd rather have fists instead. But you see how it looks here. Suit. But like I said, the only one design flaw I did not like is this piece here. I don't know, it just looks weird. It's like when you do a certain articulation, it goes up a whole lot and it exposes too much. So with all that, we'll go with articulation. John, his head back that far, that low, does have some tilt, as you can see. Raises arms up extremely high. Box swivel, double elbows, hinge in the wrist, as you can see. Turn all the way around. His upper joints, side to side. Move far back, as you can see, this pops up right here. That's what I don't like. Wish it was more down more. But, or have it hooked around all the way around, so you at least have that. But yeah, it just exposed a lot more. It does get down waist just a little bit there. Does the splits by that far, as you can see. Kick up that high, you barely kick back. Double knees, back that far, and go for that much. Okay, got a toe hinge, and it does have ankle rocker, depends on how you actually move his joint. So all in all, with this figure here, if you got all the most of the Justice League figures of these, trust me, he is a must have. And now with John, we're gonna do some size comparisons and see how everybody's acts up to him. And first off the bat, here we go. Next to the McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse, the Flash. Looking off the chain, kind of like how this looks. About the same height right there. And have these on this shelf. Gonna look off the chain. Now next, I know we got John Stewart as Green Lantern. Now we gotta have Hal Jordan as well.
He ain't lying.
Cause I gotta have a Hal Jordan. Cause he's the original. I like him. You know what I'm saying? I like him. But I need my Hal Jordan. And up next, he stacks up next to the 1,000 issue McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse Batman. Looking off the chain, like I said, I like this figure. I like how this looks, and I can't wait to have this on my shelf. And I can't wait to take some pictures and everything. So this is gonna look off the chain. So I just can't wait. And last but not least, this is a stack up next to the 1,000 issue McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse Superman. I like the Superman. Like I said, just wish a couple of parts was a little bit different, but I do like the Superman. I wish he would have that same body mode as that infected Superman. To try to make a different one of him. Everything would have been perfect. Like a perfect version of him. But I do like this one here. And this is my review of the McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse Green Lantern John Stewart. Hope y'all enjoyed this review. Cause trust me, your boy had a fun time making it. And you know, with every review, I do take pictures. This is my Instagram right here, and I will have links down below. We going to check those out. And this is my TikTok, where I take those same pictures. I just post over there, but I just add a little bit of flair. This is your boy, CB Hunts. Hope you have a blessed one. Trust me, I will be catching you in that next one. Peace.